How do you manage your calendar? Maybe you're a senior person and you have an assistant to do it, or you manage on your own. The problem is, our time is limited and many people want to interact with us. How do you do that? It's always to and fro negotiation, saying, when are you free? When am I free? And if there are multiple people involved, it's even worse. For example, I am the boss. I have to do one-on-one appraisal with people. Or I'm a part of an interview committee and I have to attend so many interviews, but I can't do it alone. I need two more people with me. All this wastes so much time. So in order to block time, we are wasting each other's time. Doesn't make sense. There has to be a better way. There is. That's called bookings. Now, I want multiple people to arrange appointments with me, but I don't want the overhead of arranging and negotiating. What do I do? Solution is, go to bookings. If you have Office 365, you do have bookings with you. So when you go to bookings, you will see two distinct parts. One is your booking things and one is shared services. So multiple people are offering some services and you want those to be blocked. So let's go to personal booking page. When you go there, again, you have two types. One is the kind of services you as a person offer, and then anyone who is having access to your booking page, which basically means everyone in the company, can block your time. That's like a public page. But in addition, you have private bookings as well. So what are the scenarios? Let's look at public one first. Let's say I am a mentor to multiple people in the company. Now they are allowed to have some time with me one-on-one. I don't want to waste time blocking their time or they struggling to find when am I free. So I create a calendar for mentoring. Similarly, I create a bookings page for consulting because I am a subject matter expert on efficiency and anyone in the company needs anything, they can block my time and get the consulting done. So these are my skills which I offer in a structured way. Now, when are people supposed to arrange a meeting with you? You don't want to give all your time. That they can do in a normal calendar meeting. You want to specifically block slots for this activity. So what am I doing? I am saying not my regular hours. I'm going to say custom availability. And now you get complete control as to which days, which time slots, and how many per day. Only 1 hour on Monday and 1 hour on Thursday I've kept. And it's a 30-minute thing. So 4 slots in a week, like that. Of course, you have more options as well. Like if there is there a lead time or lag time. I'm just going to leave that blank. So once you save it, anybody who comes to your booking page will be able to block your time. You can also send them a link. In fact, there's a very nice option here which says, put your booking page link itself in your email signature. Because when you send mail, people anyway see your signature. If they need a meeting with you, just click there. Very smart way of doing. Similar thing can happen with private also. Exactly the same thing. For example, I want to do appraisal. One-on-one 30-minute meetings with my subordinates, direct reports. Same thing I'll do, but this time I'll keep it private and I will send the link to them. Each one will go there. Now, when the other party goes there, what happens? Oh, they see your time slots. They choose the one they want. They put some details and confirm. The moment it is done, both of you get a meeting request. The other kind of things you can do with bookings is shared booking pages, which means it's not specific to one person, it's specific to an activity or service. For example, interviews. There's a panel of people who are going to take the interview and all of them have to be there. Now here, it is not my personal page. So it asks, is it only you or other people? You can add more people and then you set up the service. You can change the configuration of time slots like we saw before. And then the updated service link is available. So now the candidates, you send the link, they will look at available slots, they will block it, and job is done. Now, when you go to modify a service, everything which we describe right now can be customized exactly to your advantage. When do we use it? I just show you a couple of scenarios, but let me tell you many more scenarios because maybe some of them are applicable to you. So if you are a wealth manager, you want to arrange meetings with your high net worth individuals, parent-teacher meetings, you are a consulting doctor, you want to have consulting slots or psychologist, therapist, gyms, instructors, retail stores also, there may be assisted shopping, you are a high-end tailor and you want time slots for measurement, all of that. Whatever I showed you just now was for internal purpose, but you can expose it to external parties. That means this is like your business scheduling software. Your customers do not need any special software. They just need a browser and internet. And you can actually have pricing also included. For internal work, there will not be pricing, but look at the options available. So many variations in pricing also are supported. As though this is not enough, Bookings integrates with Power Automate. So any action happening in booking level, you get a trigger. And then you can have further automation like notifying people or arranging resources and so on. In fact, lots of new features are coming to Bookings. The roadmap for that is shown here. The link is in the description. The bottom line, I am sure you did not know so much about how Bookings can be useful to you. Whether you are junior, senior, internal, external, at least one scenario you will find. So start using it. And of course, like, share, subscribe, comment, you know that part. And related to calendar, there is another great video. In fact, two videos I have created. Have a look at it. Outlook Calendar Best Practices, Part 1 and 2. But that's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.